thank you for being with me in this session again. Today there are few questions for you that I would like to ask before you know moving with this session. So do you know what is interest rate? Or I would like to ask you, do you know what is discount points? Do you know what is the difference between qualifying rate as well as in note rate? Have you heard about note rate? Do you know what is note rate? Do you know what is qualifying rate? What are discount points? What kind of different products that you know based on interest only, as well as what are those factors on which our credit, our interest rate depends. But few people get loan on lower interest rate, few people get loan on the higher interest rate, right? So there are something which determine what interest rate on or they are going to charge me or for a particular borrower, correct? Do you have any idea? If you have, that's very good. If you don't have, please be with me and we are going to discuss all this information. There are number of questions that could be asked, but just go back to your career and find whether is there anyone who asked you what is interest rate, what is the nature of interest rate, what are those different interest rates, or what are that amortization, right, number of months, how anyone or lender or broker or loan officer, how they dictate terms of interest rate to borrower. I must say that no one asked, because there could be some secret, like nobody want to discuss about interest rate, especially when with the borrower or with the other people, because that is the only earning source of earnings for all of us. But that is not reality. In reality, when we are in this business, we have to discuss about interest rate, and we should have very good understanding of this interest rate, because that is the foundation, as I already told you, that is the foundation of all earnings in this business, right? So we should have at least a basic understanding of interest rate, and that is what we are going to discuss. So till now, what we have discussed in this 10.03, we discussed about mortgage applied for, remember, FHA, VA, conventional, others, USDA, then agency case numbers, very important term, that was like Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, and Jenny Mae, right? Then lender case number, what is the importance of lender case number, how we are going to determine who is the Sudesh. By the way, my name is Sudesh Kumar, as you must be knowing, but still I am telling it again. So lender case number, there could be 100 of Sudesh who have applied for a loan. How they are going, or anyone who is in that transaction, how they are going to find which one is the particular Sudesh whose file they want to review. So that is why lender case number, it's an important term. Then amount, loan amount, it was one of the interesting part, interesting session, I would say. And I'm very much sure that all of you who are just going through with me, going through this video with me, they must have gone through all these videos. If you haven't, I would say please go through those videos. Those are very important. Once you will go through them, if you can at least get 50% of idea what we have discussed so far, that is going to help us to move forward. Whenever I'm going to share with you different terms, so those terms are going to help us to understand the next concept of what we are discussing. Okay, so share this video with your colleagues, with your friends, with your whoever want to start their career in this field, or who have already started and they are in very basic processes. Please share this, because this is the some kind of information which should be known to each and every person who is in mortgage, whether he is in IT, whether he is in BPO, whether he is in KPO, right? He is in closing, funding, or maybe he is in some kind of management side from the management side. Still, they all should have these basic idea about the mortgage. Okay, so let's start what we are going to discuss today. So interest rate, as I have already told you, we all are running behind interest rate. We want to get, or we want to, sell a loan on higher and higher interest rate so that we can get benefited from that interest rate, and that is how we can make some money in our pocket and we can go happily to our homes. So let's see how it flows. So the first term, that is note rate. You must have gone through 1003, you must have gone through your platform or whatever LOS, loan operating system, you are using. If you haven't identified or you haven't given much focus on that, you can go back today to your loan application and you can see there is a term that is note rate. So when it comes to note rate, whenever borrower is going to take a loan, right, they are finding a loan, the first and almost thing they used to ask from loan officer or from lender or from bank, that what is the interest rate going on, what interest rate they will be getting. I mean, each borrower would like to get lower and lower and lower interest rate. But a document that is being called a note, N-O-T-E, note or promissory note, right? In that note, each and every term of the paying back the loan, the borrower loan ko pay back karega, kis term pe pay karega, right? Wo terms us note ke andar likhi hogi. So the first of thing, main purpose kya? Interest rate, har koi interest rate hi kamana chahta, right? So us note mein jo, us note, promissory note mein jo borrower sign karke deta hai, right? उस नोट के अंदर जो इंटरेस्ट रेट लिखा होता है कि मैं प्रिंसिपल अमाउंट इस इंस्टॉलमेंट में पे करूंगा और पर मंथ और मेरा जो इंटरेस्ट रेट होगा, दैट इज व्हाट माय इंटरेस्ट रेट विल बी, राइट? सो नोट रेट और इंटरेस्ट रेट इज द सेम. सो नोट पे जितना भी इंटरेस्ट रेट लिखा है, दैट इज व्हाट द नोट रेट, एंड दैट इज सिंपल इंटरेस्ट. सिंपल इंटरेस्ट मीन्स वट एवर द इंटरेस्ट रेट डिसाइडेड और टोल्ड टू मी at the very initial stage by loan officers or at the time of approval, right? So that interest rate is going to be on my note document. I'm going to sign that. I'm going to make a promise that, okay, I took this much of loan amount from so and so and so lender, and now with this interest rate I'm going to pay back all the principal amount plus this interest rate. So the interest rate written on the note document, that is being called as a note rate, and that is what promised by the approval by the underwriter on the basis of that interest rate that has been approved. Okay, now the next term is qualifying rate, right? Have you heard about this qualifying rate? What is this qualifying rate? Have you heard? No problem. So when you go to your simple note or simple document, you most of the cases you will see that note rate and qualifying rate, both terms are written on your LOS, right, or any other document. But maybe 60 to 80% you will see both are same. If it's 5%, it could be 5% as well, most of the cases. So let's see what is the difference between note rate and qualifying rate. What happens, there is an ability to repay, right? After, especially in 2007 or 2008, when the real estate market was almost down time. After that, there is a new concept that has been implemented while approving the loan, that is ADR, ability to repay. Ability to repay means each and every lender, they have to calculate, a payment shock, or maybe I would say ability of borrower, whether borrower is able to make the payment after receiving this loan or not. So that is the simple definition for what I am saying, ADR, right? So that is on the basis of that ADR, or when it comes to qualifying rate, especially when the next term, that is amortization. that is loan amortization. Loan amortization is the next term that we are going to discuss. That time, whatever I am saying about the qualifying rate may get more clarity to you. But let me try if I can clarify it here only. So when it comes to ability to repay, it's a kind of like, we know that 5% is the interest rate, right? But there are different products that we are going to discuss on the amortization. Have you heard about the ARM product? ARM means adjustable rate mortgage, right? So that interest rate goes as per the index. If maybe this year interest rate or the index has lowered, so interest rate will go down. But maybe next year index will go up and interest rate will also shoot. Will go up. Okay, so in that case, what happens? Each and every lender, they want to calculate 5% is a note rate plus 2%, because that is what they are assuming, that maybe if the index goes high, there could be 2% more hike to his interest rate. So 5 will become 2 plus 7%, right? So in that, just to make sure whether if the interest rate or index shoots 2% higher, whether loan borrower will still be able to make the payment or with those increased 2%, like borrower ka interest rate 5% hai, that is note rate abhi ke hisab se. But lender usko plus 2% karke ek baar qualify kara ke dekhte hai kya borrower is still qualifying. Like उसकी मान लो उसका जो प्रिंसिपल पेमेंट बनता है, पेमेंट कैसे बनता है, पेमेंट बनता है लाइक कि कुछ पार्ट प्रिंसिपल का, बाकी का पर मंथ का इंटरेस्ट रेट, राइट? सो इंटरेस्ट रेट के हिसाब से उसकी इंस्टॉलमेंट बनती है. सो मान लो उसकी प्रिंसिपल की इंस्टॉलमेंट है या अमाउंट है वो है $500, राइट? प्लस इंटरेस्ट रेट उसका पर मंथ का बनता है 5% के हिसाब से $50, राइट? This is what the interest rate per month. So it will become 550. But let's suppose if instead of 5% interest rate, index goes higher after 1 year or 2 years, and by 2% at least, or it becomes 7%, right? So calculation will be done on this amount, will be done on the basis of that 7%, and it may become 80% or $80, or it could become $60. So whether borrower will still be, I'm just giving you an example. So $60 and $50 seems very, very low, but it doesn't go in that way. It comes like $250, or it's sometimes more than the principal amount, right? So it could be a big shock to borrower, and maybe if after 2 years when index will go higher, borrower may not be able to make that payment. हो सकता है कि borrower अभी तो payment कर रहा है, but 2 साल के बाद जब index high चला जाता है, सो उस वक्त बॉरर क्वालिफाई कर पाएगा उस इंडेक्स के हिसाब से कि नहीं, उसको पहले से ही काउंट करके देख लेते हैं लेंडर. सो ऑन दैट बेसिस लेंडर क्या करते हैं, अलग से गाइडलाइंस होती है इसकी. इफ यू विल बी इन सम काइंड ऑफ प्राइसिंग प्रोसेस, देन यू विल हैव मोर क्लैरिटी ऑन दैट, बिकॉज वी आर नॉट डिस्कसिंग द प्रोसेस हियर. सो आई एम नॉट गोइंग डीप इन दैट, but whenever we will discuss about the pricing process, definitely we will go into that and you will get more clarity. But mota mota agar aapko check karna hai, so that is what ki qualifying rate is lender, after 2 years or 3 years after, if a payment gets shock, a higher shock, to us shock ko borrower jhel payega ki nahi jhel payega, right? In that case borrower uske 5% pe or 2% or whatever index can go, or there could be some cap that we are going to discuss, what are cap, how index goes high, what happens when it goes low, what happens when it goes very high, right? We are going to discuss that in next session, that is our amortization, that will be related to amortization, okay? But as of now, just to make you understand on the qualifying rate, so whenever borrower, even we know that 5% borrower is qualifying for the rate, but still because he's on the basis of his product, that could be adjustable rate mortgage. So if he has chosen the adjustable rate mortgage, so we need to check whether if index goes high and his interest rate goes, his payment goes high. So whether that time borrower will be able to make the payment or not. So that is how we are going to qualify his loan of in the current time. So hope you got some clarity on these terms. But I promise you, next time when we are going to discuss the amortization type, ARM type, different fixed rate, what are fixed rate, what is GPM, right? So when we are going to discuss all those terms, you will have more clarity to understand what I am talking about. But if you still need more clarifications, please write on the comment and I will give you, or will collect some more example and will share you and will clarify, make it as an easy example. Okay, so now the next is APR. You must have heard, if you are already working in the mortgage field, you must have heard about the APR. APR, when it comes to APR, APR means annual percentage rate. Have you heard about them? No, if that is not possible, if you are working in the mortgage field or if you have ever gone through a loan estimate, you will never going to forget this term. It is one of the important term in the interest rate. And when we say annual percentage of rate, there is a very, you know, secret information in between note rate and APR. What happens? Whenever we start working in the mortgage, when we work in the mortgage, what happens? We only read the terms and then we do the data entry and we move. Because most of the times, the interest, the whole part is not a part of the all processes, right? So even if you are working in the underwriting process and if you are not doing the repricing that time, that you won't be having any more challenges related to interest rate. Especially when you are in subprime mortgage and there you have to have your interest rate as well as your pricing done by yourself. That time you will get more clarity on that. But when it comes to prime mortgage, because there is almost every time I saw that there is this different or separate pricing department, we used to call that block desk, right? So they do all these stuff, so rest of the part is not very much involved in the interest rate, right? But because we are in this field, we are working in this mortgage, so we have to have all the information about, right? So what is APR? APR means annual percentage rate. What happens when I am saying I am getting a loan on the 5%, right? 5% on the interest rate. My loan amount is $100,000 is my loan amount, and I have been offered 5% interest rate, right? So 5% interest rate for 30 years. I'm taking a loan for 30 years. Now what happens if 30 years they are going to count 5% for 100,000 for 30 years? That is what mortgage payment is going to be calculated according to that, right? But when it comes to APR, APR means whether I'm only liable to pay 5% or there is something else that is I'm also paying, right? So when I go for a loan, I pay them closing cost, right? I'm paying them closing fee, closing cost. That is known. I'm paying them closing cost from my pocket. I'm paying for many other documents like appraisal fee. I'm paying for settlement charges, right? CD. Settlement charges, whatever settlement charges, then there is one more discount points. I'm going to define that, but I'm also paying for that, you know, buy downs. I'm also paying that. So all this money, where it is going? So when I'm calculating all these discounts, and there could be other charges as well. So when I'm paying all this payment, who is paying? I mean, I'm not only paying 5% what as per the terms, but I'm also making all these payments. So whatever the interest rate is calculated for 30 years, right? Plus all these charges, when I at maybe I'm paying it almost $10,000, and for 30 years if my interest rate would be 5% for the 1,000, so let's take it, I'm going around maybe it's a $20,000, just a hypothetical example. So 30,000 plus 10,000 total, again 30,000. Now my APR would be according to that 30,000. When I'm going to calculate, that 30,000 in the next 30 years, and if I'm calculating the total percentage, so that would be my annual percentage rate, because that is what I pay. It is not only the interest rate that I pay to the lender. There are lot many other pieces which costed me, right? I paid that to the lender, to the loan officer, mostly to the lender at the closing time, or sometimes prepaid charges as well, right? So all those charges, when we add with that 5% interest rate which I am going to make in the next 30 years, or even if my loan is for 10 years, then I am going to calculate club both those amount, both those total expenses, then I add that and create a percentage per month. That is what my per year APR. Getting my point? I hope that I was able to clarify, but if I am not, I will try to go once more, right? You can write in the comment, I can either clarify on the comments, or whatever information I can share with you, I can provide you that, or if needed more examples, I will definitely share that with you in my next video as well. Okay, let me know if you didn't get the understanding what I was my intention was shared. Okay, so note rate, qualifying rate, and now APR is again clarified. So let's go to discount points. What are discount points? Have you heard about? Especially when you go to 1003, there is a section number 7, right? 7 or 8. So there is a detail of transactions. Go to that DOT section. We used to call it DOT section, detail of transactions. Go to that section, see how many charges are being paid there by borrower, right? Most of the time, or sometimes 90% cases, you will see there are some discount points, some seller discount points, some lender concessions or discount, or you could see buy down. So I would say first let's see what are discount points. So discount point, what happens, like in the current scenario, I told you already that 5% is the interest rate for this loan. Now my lender has given me an option that if I'm going to pay, I mean they are saying that because my loan amount is 100,000, right? 100,000 is my loan amount. He is saying if I am going to pay 1% of that loan amount in an advance mein agar main uska 1% jama karata hu, pay kar deta hu lender ko, then they are going to reduce the interest rate by 0.25%. If my 1% of my 100,000 is $1,000. $1,000 is my 1% of 100,000, right? So if I am paying 1,000 in an advance to my lender, they are going to reduce my interest rate 0.25% from my note rate, right? So it will become 4.75%, right? Right, and it will remain throughout the life of the loan. So that is how, if I am going to pay it, they have decided that whoever is going to make the payment 1%, we are going to reduce 25%. So that is one discount point. If I am going to make the payment of 2,000, obviously it will go down by some more points, like. So that is how it works, discount points. I'm sure you get an idea. It's a very simple term, okay? So now buy down, again buy down, if somebody want to buy down these points in front before the loan close or at the time of close, obviously they're the same thing. Discount points or buy downs are the nature of these calculations are same, only the name are different. Next is credit score. Now, why I'm writing here the credit score, or let's see what are credit score first, or why they are here. When I go to take a loan from a bank, the bank first asks me what are my credit score, or they themselves can check what are my credit score. My credit score show the history of my payments in the previous days, till now, how many loans I took, how I paid them, how many time I was disqualified, how many time I defaulted, I was not able to make the payments. So on the basis of all that information, they decide, or credit bureau, they decide the credit score for me, right? More credit score, if I have higher credit score, that means my interest rate will go down. I mean, I will get low interest rate from the lender. I mean, they will see, okay, this person is very very decent credit score, so let's give him a lower interest rate because there is less risk, right? But when it comes down, my interest rates are, or my sorry, credit scores are down, naturally I will have my file will have higher interest rate. And if someone is going to take higher risk, they obviously going to charge more interest rate. So higher credit score, low interest rate. Low credit score, high interest rate, right? Okay, so that is how. Now the interest only, there are different products that depends on the interest. I mean, those have been made only for the interest rate purpose. What happens sometimes, maybe some of the borrower who just joined the job, recently started his first job, and now he wanted to buy a home for himself, and now he goes to lender and say, or bank, that he say that okay, as of now I just started with the company, and my salary is low, my expenses are high, but within the next year, or within a year, or within couple of years, I'm going to be improving in my field, I'm going to be improve in my job, and my salary or my earnings are also going to increase, right? That time I will be able to make the more payments. So let's see, give me a loan, whatever the interest loan, 100,000, put it aside, whatever the interest rate, I will keep making the payment. I mean, I will keep making the payment per month, payment only for interest rate. So whatever interest rate is counted for this 100,000, right, whatever it comes, like maybe it comes 1,000 per month, so borrower is saying I will make those 1,000 per month till the next 3 years, and after those 3 years you can re-amortize the loan, and then I will start making the full payment, right? So that is how different products are. So there is one product, interest only, because it has the name interest only. We used to call it negative amortization as well, but we are going to discuss that in the next session. Now the lock desk, next is lock desk. Kya hota hai? It is a separate process. Whenever from the beginning, as soon as the file gets started, there is a desk which we used to call lock desk. Lock desk means, or sometimes we used to call it pricing desk as well, because they do all the pricing, all the maths, all in this, what interest rate going to be, they are going to consider different factors, what kind of the product code borrower could be, is most suitable for the borrower, what would be the interest rate on different factors like credit scores, his history, his income, everything, whatever, as per their guidelines. So that is what the lock desk. When it comes to lock desk, however, it's a part of loan estimate, or we see more information on the loan estimate, but still I wanted to share some insights of this lock desk, especially what happens. The main purpose of this lock desk is not only to decide or declare the interest rate, but also that sometimes what happens, maybe this time interest rates are low, so loan officer, whenever they find any borrower, they give them an option that okay, see, this time today index is low, interest rate is just 3% for your transactions, but index can go higher in next 5 days or in next 15 days. So instead of, you know, and that time the your interest rate, what we are telling you today, is 5%, will increase to the maybe to 6 or 7%. So from, you know, you can save yourself, or you can lock your 5 or your interest rate especially on this today. And even after 3 days, after 5 days or after 15 days, if index goes high, because your interest rate is already locked, so it won't have any impact of that index. That is what the main purpose of this lock was. Okay, and they used to lock their 5s or their interest rate for a certain period of time, like 15 days, 30 days, 60 days, 90 days, and they can renew as well. Sometimes what happens when index is 3% or interest rate is 3%, after 15 days, if interest rate is 2.5%, that time borrower has that option that we can opt for that interest, lower interest rate, instead of the 3% which locked. He can unlock the file. They will unlock the file and they will lock it again. Or even, it's not that all the borrowers, they lock their file. Sometimes borrowers say, no, we don't want to lock it as of now. We'll see later, and that is how the file moves. But before file gets closed, or before closing, at least within next 24 to 48 hours, every file gets locked, so that even in between then everything is ready, file is approved, and almost is in the closing, they lock the lock the interest rate, so that it does not make any impact on the file before closing. Okay, I hope that I have given you a lot of clarifications. I made it simple for you, and I was able to clarify as well as make you understand about the interest rate and the different terms of the interest rate. Still, if you have anything comes to your mind, any additional term you want to know about the interest rate, any information, please do share it with me on through the comment, and don't forget to share these videos, these sessions, this information with your colleagues, with your friends, with someone who is just starting with this job, or who want to, who have desire to work in this video field. Please share this information with them as well. The next topic is about motivation and them, confident that if some of any of the terms which is not clarified today, that could be clarified on the basis of next session, and that is motivation time. So till then, keep safe. Thank you.